We want to solve the given linear equation. Normally when solving a linear equation in one variable, we expect one solution, but that's not always the case. Let's attempt to solve this equation and see what happens. Following the guidelines to solve multi-step equations, the first thing we do for this equation would be to simplify each side by clearing parentheses and combining like terms. Notice on the left side we have two constant terms. On the right side, we have two x terms. So on the left side, 9 minus 5 is equal to 4, and therefore the left side simplifies to 4 plus 4x, or 4x plus 4. Now on the right side, 8x minus 4x is 4x, the right side simplifies to 4x plus 14. The next step is to add or subtract to isolate the variable term. Notice right now we have variable terms on both sides of the equation. If we're trying to isolate the variable, we need the variable terms on one side. So to undo the positive 4x on the right side of the equation, let's subtract 4x on both sides. And now let's simplify both sides. On the left side, 4x minus 4x is 0. The left side simplifies to 4, so we have 4 equals. On the right side, we also have 4x minus 4x. The right side simplifies to 14. So notice, in the process of isolating the variable terms simplify out, and we're left with the equation 4 equals 14. Well, we know 4 equals 14 is false. So because this equation is false, that means there are no solutions to the original linear equation. So we can say the equation has no solutions. Again, in the process of solving the equation, if the variable terms simplify out and the resulting equation is false, this indicates the equation has no solutions. And sometimes we say the solution does not exist, or DNE for short, DNE for does not exist. Let's look at a second example. We have the same type of equation, so for the first step we'll simplify both sides of the equation. On the left we have two x terms, on the right we have two constant terms. So on the left side, 8x minus 6x is 2x, the left side simplifies to 2x plus 9. On the right side, 12 minus 3 is equal to 9, the right side simplifies to 9 plus 2x, or if we want 2x plus 9. Now looking at the equation closely, notice how the expression on the left is exactly the same as the expression on the right, which means this is going to be true for any value of x, and therefore there's an infinite number of solutions. But if we don't recognize this, the next step would be to add or subtract to isolate the variable term. So to undo the positive 2x on the right side, we would subtract 2x on both sides. And now we'll simplify. On the left, 2x minus 2x is 0. The left side simplifies to 9, so we have 9 equals. On the right, 2x minus 2x is also 0. Notice how the right side also simplifies to 9. So once again, in the process of isolating the variable terms simplified out, but the resulting equation now is true. 9 equals 9 is always true. So because this equation is true, and there are no variables in it, this indicates the original equation has an infinite number of solutions. Which again means any value of x is going to satisfy the equation or make the equation true. And sometimes we just write infinite solutions for short. So when solving a linear equation, we normally expect to have one solution, but it is possible to have an infinite number of solutions as well as no solutions. If an equation has no solutions, it can be classified as a contradiction equation. So this equation is a contradiction equation. And if an equation has an infinite number of solutions, as we see here, this can be classified as an identity equation. And if a linear equation in one variable has one solution, it can be classified as a conditional equation. I hope you found this helpful.